War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war. War never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Such pretty eyes.
I clean up pretty nice.
Handsome as the day we met.
Not bad. Not bad.
What's different about you?
Looking good, if I do say so myself.
I like it. Makes you look younger.
Hey, hon.
I'll just be a minute.
I wonder what Sean will grow up to be. He'll either be great at spelling or great at smashing blocks together.
Ah, good morning, sir. Your coffee. 173.5 degrees Fahrenheit. Brewed to perfection. And today's newspaper just...
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
That's right. Which is why we...
Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, sir.
Sugar bombs. 100% daily value of sugar. Nuka-Cola. Ice cold. Saddle up Salisbury steak. Graded A+. Looks like the milk got delivered.
Now, sounds like someone made a stick. I shall attend to young
Hey, hon.
Shore.
Wow, look at you. How'd a girl like me ever get so lucky, huh?
More of the same.
You know, I was nervous at first, but Codsworth's really good with Sean. Can't believe it's almost Halloween. Oh, need to finish making Sean's costume. Can you get that? It's probably that salesman.
Good morning! Vault-Tec calling.
I'm referring, of course, to our great national pastime. Vault-Tec? Remind me again?
Why, we're about you, sir, and helping secure your future. You see, Vault-Tec is the four. Foremost builder of state-of-the-art underground fallout shelters. Vaults, if you will. Luxury accommodations where you can wait out the horrors of nuclear devastation. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
What's so important?
Why, nothing less than your entire future. If you haven't noticed, sir, this country has gone to heck in a handbasket. If you'll excuse my language, the big kaboom is... It's inevitable, I'm afraid. And coming sooner than you may think, if you catch my meaning. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your... I'm here today to tell you that because of your family's service to our country...
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Now, I can't wait for the world to end.
That's the spirit. Now, let's see. Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
You heard
hey, Codsworth.
Go
Mr.
on.
Philip, if I may, Sean requires your personal attention. A boy needs his father, after all.
How are the two most important men in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that. Hey, how's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Yeah, sounds like fun.
Sir? Mom? You should come and see this!
Codsworth? What's wrong?
Followed by... Yes, followed by flashes, blinding flashes. Sounds of explosions. We're, trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with
say?
Our affiliate stations. We do have coming in. That's, confirmed reports, I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh my God.
We need to get to the vault. Now!
I've got Sean. Let's go.
Residents of Sanctuary Hills, if you are registered, evacuate to Vault 111 immediately.
Need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant, adult male, adult female. Okay, go ahead.
Thank you.
Good luck,
ma'am. You two, follow me. Come on.
What's gonna happen to all those people outside the gate?
We're doing everything we can. Now keep moving.
Almost there. We're gonna be okay. I love you. Both of you.
We love you too. We did it. We made it. We're okay.
Everyone, please, step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
No need to worry, folks. We'll get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111. A better future underground.
So we just...
Yes, up the stairs.
I can't believe it. If we left a minute later...
No, no.
We don't.
Don't get caught up thinking about that. You're safe now. Everyone, just head up these stairs and through the door there.
Just this way, please.
Vault Tech is here for you.
Hell.
This All
way.
New residents,
this way, please.
Please proceed in an orderly
just
fashion.
This way.
Well, good. Male.
Step over to the table. Female in suit. Just step over to the table.
Those are good.
Welcome. Pick up a suit right over there. Right over there.
You'll need your
over
suits
there.
Before we can take you further.
Good. Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show you where to go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
See? This is our new home.
Oh, you're gonna love it here.
Here you are.
This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home. Everything we had.
My mother and father down in D.C.
Sir?
Oh, God, honey. What if they didn't make it?
How long do you think we'll be down here?
Move along.
Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Don't you think?
The vault suit is designed to be fashionable as well as comfortable.
Prepared for the future, right?
Just step in here and put your vault suit on. Pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper in the hall. Just relax.
Time for a whole new life.
Resident secure. Occupant vitals normal. Procedure complete. In.
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on, come on, come on! Oh, God!
I'll find who did this.
Critical.
And I'll get Sean back.
Biogenic array.
I promise.
The deuce must vacate.
Giant roaches? What the hell? happened here? Where is everyone? Is this all that's left? Nice. Coming back later for you. It's really strong. Is anyone alive? Did anyone get out? Oh, God.
Thank you.
Vault door cycling sequence initiated. Please stand back.
So, this radio station here, we don't really make any caps, and, there are, well, some people help me stay in the air. People like this. Stop in for a drink at the Dugout Inn. The stories are free, but the moonshine will cost.
Codsworth? You're still here.
So other people could still be alive, too.
But of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the wife see you in that state, hmm? Where is the missus, by the way?
She's in a better place.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love...
Uh-huh. Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little. For the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're two centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing. And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car... The car! How do you polish rust?
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. Give me the word, sir, and I'll initiate my search for Thor.
It moves me.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir. Movement in another house. Follow me. What's all this?
Sean's out there, Codsworth. I need to find him.
What about Concord, sir? Plenty of people there. And last I checked, they only pummeled me with sticks a few times before I had to run back home.
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station?
I shall remain here and secure the home front.
I hope you enjoyed that last song.
Okay. Coming to you from the jewel green. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth. It's Diamond City Radio! Here's Bob Crosby with Way Back Home.
The roads are the dustiest, the winds are the gustiest, the gates are the...
There must be someone who can help you in Concord.
The lustiest, the friends, the trustiest, way back home,
back home.
The trees are the sappiest, the days are the nappiest, the dogs are the yappiest, the kids are the scrappiest, the jokes the snappiest, the folks the happiest way back home. Don't know why I left the homestead, I really must confess. I'm a weary exile, singing my song of loneliness. The grass is the springiest, the bees are the stingiest, the birds are the wingiest, the bells are the ringiest, the heart's the singiest, the arms the clingiest way. The fruitiest, stars the shootiest,
the grin's the funniest,
the smile's the sunniest way back home. Don't know why I left the homestead, I really must confess. I'm a weary exile, singing my song of home. The spreadiest, the wine is the headiest, the pals are the readiest, the gals are the steadiest, the love the liveliest, the life the loveliest, way back,
here all by yourself?
I'm as corny as Kansas City.
You seem like an okay guy. Okay, then. Let's stick together.
Hey.
I am in a conventional dinner with a conventional star in my eye. And you will note there's a lump in my throat when I speak of that wonderful guy. I'm as trident, as gay as a daisy in May, a cliche coming true. I'm bromidic and bright as a moon, happy night pouring light on the dew. I'm as corny as Kansas in August, high as a flag on the 4th of July. If you'll excuse an expression I use, I'm in love, 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 I'm in love with a wonderful guy.
Hey. Wait there. Come on.
I'm as trident, as gay as the daisy in May, a cliche coming true. I'm bromidic and bright as the moon, happy night pouring light on the dew. I'm as corny as Kansas in August, high as a flag on the 4th of July. If you'll excuse an expression I use, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love with a wonderful
City Radio, and I'm Travis. Was I the only one surprised that Skeeter Davis is, you know, a woman? It's just, it doesn't really sound like his name. Hey, who are you writing that poem for? Skeeter!
You got to access, create the positive, eliminate the negative, latch on to the affirmative, don't mess the mister in between. You got to latch on. Just when everything looks so dark, man, they said we better act and with positive feeling. Money to negative, latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess the mister in between. No, don't mess the mister in between.
Sold my cad, I bought me a Jeep, I got that bug and I can't sleep.
Uranium fever has come and got me down. Uranium fever is spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to take me some government land.
Uranium fever has come and got me down.
Well, I had a talk with the AEC and they brought out some maps that looked good to me. And one showed me a spot he said he knowed. So I straddled my Jeep and headed down the road. I reckon I drove about 100 miles down a bumpy road out through the wilds. When all of a sudden I bounced a stop at the foot of a mountain, didn't have no top.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever is spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
I'm going out to take me some government land.
Uranium fever has done and got me down.
Well, I took the Geiger and a star. Geiger and I started to climb right up to the top where I thought I'd find a hunk of rock that'd make it click just like I'd read about Vernon Pitt. On the second day I made the top and I'm telling you, Steve, I was ready to stop. The only clicking that I heard that day was the bones in my back that had gone astray.
Uranium fever has done and got me down. Uranium fever, it's spreading all around.
With a Geiger counter in my hand,
uranium fever.
You reach a spot where your fortune lies. Well, I counter in my hand.
I'm going out to take me some
government
land. Uranium fever has got and got me down.
Hey, up here, on the balcony. I've got a group of settlers inside. The raiders
that
are
was,
almost through the door.
Uranium
grab that laser
by,
musket and help us,
oh,
please!
By Elton Britt. Yes, right, it says so, right there. This radio station, here, we don't really make any caps, and, there are, well, some people help me stay in the air, people like this, squatters, own a piece of Diamond City history, and then beat people to death with it. So, right, okay. Let's just listen to the song by the Three Sons.
Rock's really strong.
Well, there's Three Sons. We'll be dead soon.
No more British occupation!
Next, we've got Betty Hutton. She's pretty good.
No more British occupation!
Everybody?
Aren't you English with you?
Girls!
Have your key back, you!
Your step. It's a man. If it acts just like it's the boss, when it knows that you are, of course, it gets a little rough, things very tough.
Where'd that little fucker go?
Man, I don't know who you are, but your timing's impeccable. Preston Garvey, Commonwealth Minutemen.
God damn it.
Minutemen? So now I'm traveling backward in time?
Protect the people at a minute's notice. That was the idea. So I joined up, wanted to make a difference. And I did, but things fell apart. Now it looks like I'm the last Minuteman left standing.
Who are these people?
Just folks looking for a new home, a fresh start. I've been with them since Quincy. Lexington looked good for a while, but the ghouls drove us out of there. A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. It's just me, the Longs, Marcy and June. That's old Mama Murphy on the couch. And this here is Sturgis.
Hey.
Sorry. Sounds rough.
Thanks. It's good to meet someone who really cares. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
Will it be enough to stop those maniacs?
Sturgis, tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school, pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
What makes that power armor so special?
A Westech internalized servo system, that's what! Inside that baby, super is the new normal. You'll be stronger, tougher, resistant to rads, and... get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Huh. Could work.
It'll work, provided we can reactivate the suit. It's totally out of juice. Probably has been for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
So.
I love those dear hearts and gentle people who live in my hometown. Because those dear hearts and gentle people will never ever let you down.
Through the back room and up to the roof, I'll hold them off from here.
From
go!
A dream house I'll build there one day with picket fence and rambling rows. I feel so welcome each time that I return
that my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown. I love those dear hearts and
they read the good book.
Army Staff Sergeant Michael Daly. This past Saturday, October 23rd, while en route to West Stockbridge, a vertebrate crashed into the roof of this museum. The cause? EMP following nuclear detonation. Several, in fact. From the intel I've gathered, this was a global event. The co-pilot was killed on impact. Pilot died of his injuries a day later. Day after that, Flaherty and Kanawha were shot by some scared, desperate survivors. Then Brzezinski took off running. Haven't seen him since.
Bob Crosby this time. Not Bing.
Why don't you get down here? Show me that fancy gun.
I suppose do.
Not a lot of people can get that, my boy. I'll give you that. You're waiting, asshole.
A sort of note, I guess, from sponsor here. Thanks, and I'll,
You're awake, asshole!
Diamond City Surplus, now open 24 hours a day. Management reserves the right to refuse service to anyone, especially since.
I think I got
this
something.
Next stop is called Easy Living.
I thought I heard something.
Thank you.
every worry, love is passing me by.
That was a pretty amazing display. I'm just glad you're on our side.
You guys gonna be okay now?
Yeah, for a while anyway. We can at least move some. Listen, when we first met, you asked about the Minutemen. One thing you should know about us, we help out our friends. So here, for everything you've done, thank you.
What happens now?
For the longest time, Mama Murphy's had a vision of a place called Sanctuary. Some old neighborhood, but one we can make new again. Why don't you come with us? I could really use your help.
What would I need to do?
You'd need to stay strong like you've been. Because there's more to your destiny. I've seen it. And I know your pain.
Maybe I should go to school about love when it comes together. Please, tell me. I need to know.
You're a man out of time, out of hope. But all's not lost. I can feel your son's energy. He's alive.
Life is fine, but with a worry in mind. Where is my son? Where is Sean?
Oh, I wish I knew, kid. I really do. But it's not like I can see your son. I can just feel his life force, his energy. He's out there. And even I don't need the sight to tell you where you should start looking. The great green jewel of the Commonwealth, Diamond City, the biggest settlement around.
What's in Diamond City? Is Sean there?
Look, kid, I'm tired now. Maybe you'll bring me some chems later. The site will paint a clearer picture.
No, Mama Murphy, we talked about this. That junk is gonna kill you.
Oh, shush, Preston. We're all gonna die eventually. We're gonna need the site. And our new friend here, he's gonna need it too. Get going. Sanctuary awaits.
All right, folks. Thanks to our friend here, it's safe to move out. We're heading for that place Mama Murphy knows about. Sanctuary. It's not far.
She knows about it? You mean she had one of her visions while she was stoned out of her gourd? And now you want us to just head out on another wild goose chase based on no better plan than Mama Murphy thought?
It can hardly turn out any worse.
Everybody just take it easy. We're all in this together, right? So, Marcy, got a better idea of what we should do next? Anybody? Well then, Sanctuary it is. Let's just hope it lives up to its name.
Come on, June, it's time to go.
Oh, okay.
Help you need is in Diamond City, child.
Let's move out.
I'll take point. Stay close, everyone.
We're right behind you, boss.
Hey, do you have a moment? I wanted to thank you for helping us out in Concord. If only we'd run into you sooner.
What happened to you guys?
Long story short, we've been on the move since the attack on Quincy. There used to be more of us. My son, he's gone.
Your son? What was his name?
Kyle. My son's name was Kyle.
That's awful.
No parent should have to lose their child.
No. No, they shouldn't. I just keep thinking, maybe I could have done more. Anyway, thanks again.
I just want to trade a few things.
I feel so welcome each time that I return, that my happy heart keeps laughing like a clown.
Like a clown.
I love those dear hearts
and gentle people
who live and love in my hometown.
In my hometown, those dear hearts and gentle people.
I just want to trade a few things.
Sure, let me just stop what I'm doing to talk to you. I'm being sarcastic. Leave me alone.
I'm glad you decided to come with us. I should have listened to Mama Murphy all along. Pretty nice place she's found for us. I think we could settle down here. Make it a place to call home. What do you think?
I don't know. It's strange being back here.
What do you mean? You used to live here or something?
Yeah. Before the war. Before everything was ruined.
What do you mean? Before what war? Are you saying...
What do you think I'm saying?
Well, that you're from before the war. The Great War. Like one of those old ghouls you sometimes run into. Is that true?
Ghouls from before the war?
Yeah, I've run into a few that old. I guess ghouls don't really age. Radiation preserves them or something. Obviously, you're no ghoul, but the way you were talking made me wonder, that's all.
Yeah, sort of. I was born over 200 years ago, but I was frozen or something for most of it. Just woke up a little while ago.
Damn. Like one of those old pre-war ghouls. You say you were frozen. Anybody else make it out with you?
My son. Somebody took him away while I was still trapped. I've been looking for him.
Damn. I'm sorry. I hope you find him. Let me know if there's any way I can help. Anyway, I am glad you're here. And I hope you don't mind, but I've got another favor to ask. I've had word from a settlement asking for help. There's still hope in their Minutemen out there, somewhere. The only chance to start rebuilding the Minutemen is to show people that they can count on us when they need us. Trouble is, I've got my hands full here. Do you think you could go help out the settlement?
What kind of help do they need?
Sounded like the usual, raiders. You'll have to get all the details when you talk to them.
I'd be glad to help.
That's fantastic. The Minutemen could use more people like you. By the way, if you want to help out around here at all, talk to Sturgis. I'm sure he'd be glad for all the help he can get.
not raining.
This won't work without power.
Looks like it's in working order. Looks like it's in working order. Looks like it's in working order.
Growing well.
What?
Thank you.
sanctuary.